Hey, everybody in the focus group. This is Mark Hawkins speaking, and I want to get you rolling here with a couple of, I'm going to do three or four radio show samples, tests using the equipment, doing some very basic mixing. Today's playlist is going to have is going to be done as if we are in a cathedral, which is kind of bizarre in itself. And you know that there really isn't anything that I do normal, so it kind of goes with the territory. Anyway, I just happened to set this on cathedral, and it just means that it's going to sound like you're sitting in the back of a cathedral somewhere, and the artists are at the front. Doing a sound check or what have you. So have some fun. Grab your favorite drink, put your feet up, listen to the show, and then I would certainly appreciate any comments that you have, suggestions, critiques, that sort of thing. But I'll be doing these shows various ways. This first go round, I get to select the songs. I'll be asking people to select some songs, etc. And then I'll provide some commentary to them. And so this is the first test for Hometown Social Club. And I hope you like some of the songs that I've picked. And let's get to the first one. You'll hear some clicks of my mouse just because I'm not going to be doing any fancy editing at this point.
George, is it true that you're a connoisseur of the classics?
No, it's just a rumor.
It's just a rumor. Do you enjoy singing Beethoven?
No, I've been singing it for 28 years now.
For how long?
28 years.
That's incredible. Could you manage one more performance?
Possibly.
Oh, go on, say yes.
Yes. Thank you.
Not guilty of getting in your way while you're trying to steal the day. Not guilty, and I know before the rest I'm not trying to steal your best. I'm not trying to be small, but I only want what I can get. Really sorry for your raging head, like you heard me say, not guilty. No use handing me a writ while I'm trying to do my bit. I don't expect to take you home, but I only want what I can get. I'm really sorry that you're underfed, like you heard me say, not guilty. Thank you.
Not Guilty, as performed by the Beatles. Not Guilty was, during that tumultuous time in which the Beatles had returned from meditation with the Maharishi over in India, and had come back, and they were all pretty much doing supposedly as a band, recording the White Album. Of course, it turned out to be an album of mostly solo projects in which, every now and then one of the other band members would come into the recording studio and help. But they were pretty much all fighting at that point in time, but George didn't get much love on the White Album. He did have a few tunes, most notably While My Guitar Gently Weeps. Not Guilty was one that actually did not make it on that album. It was later found, I believe, on one of his solo albums. The next song comes from my favorite year of music, 1969. This band who performed the song was in the midst of a string of hits. It was just unbelievable for that period of time. Creedence Clearwater Revival had Proud Mary and Lodi and coming in my back. I can't remember the name of that song. There are just so many songs that they had and hits. And this particular one, I can definitely remember laying out in the backyard of Ted Springsteen's house, which was on the corner of Downing Circle East and right on the corner of Arapahoe Road, kind of a tough road to be on the corner of. But I'd spend the night laying in the backyard, and this is after my ninth grade year, just before going into high school, and I can remember listening to a lot of great music that summer. One of the songs that came out was this one, and as I'd look up in the sky at the stars on a warm summer night, we could also see the bad moon rising.
Yeah.
Yep, there's definitely a bathroom on the right in Ted Springsteen's house. One of my first jobs that I ever had was at Cinderella City, and it was selling women's shoes at a place called Allen's Shoes. And it really, truly was it was actually probably the worst job I've ever had. It was one of the first jobs I ever had. I got fired from that job. Wes Tucker, one of my friends at Arapaho High, also worked for one of the shoe stores there. And so we would, and gosh, there was a whole bunch of us that worked there at one point in time. But we would carpool and, you know, all get off the same time at 9 o'clock. This was after school, you know, and we get off at 9 o'clock and be on our way home. And I have this memory of heading home one night. I don't know. For all I know, we'd smoked a doobie. But I remember this next song, and a biggie. During that time period where Joe Cocker and Leon Russell and Mad Dogs and Englishmen. And this next song is called Ballad of Mad Dogs and Englishmen. Enjoy.
Incense burner, leader's leader, chronic leader, thieves and pirates on a ride. It's a hippie commune. Stones and future diamonds. Know which way the wind blows. The stolen coal, but no one knows. The shadow, but it's still a shame. Cause I love her, and she. just myself, I'm only friend in the name of copyright. Out here on the road again, with mad dogs and English men.
In the name of Cocker Power. That was an amazing band, Joe Cocker and Leon Russell and all those guys. I mean, talk about a troupe. That whole Mad Dogs and Englishmen tour where, gosh, it was a who's who in session players, etc. It was quite a time. We lost Joe Cocker this year. What a loss. Joe Cocker was an amazing, amazing blues man. Incredible, incredible voice. I'll never forget Saturday Night Live skit when John Belushi and Joe Cocker were out there. Did you see that? God, that was one of the most hilarious skits I've ever seen. Because Joe Cocker wasn't your usual Joe Blow. Anyway, and Belushi did him perfectly. Leon was on top of his game when he was doing this stuff, and then he, of course, became a solo, did some solo work on his you know, with his own name. And I remember going up to Folsom, packed house. I can't remember the year. I would say 72, maybe, when. A person who actually later on became his wife, a person by the name of Mary McCrary, came on first, and then Little Feet came on, and God, Little Feet. And then Leon closed the show. That's how big Leon was. It wasn't all that long ago that Leon was, people had kind of forgotten about old Leon, and Elton John comes around and says, "Hey, buddy, you're not dead yet. Let's do an album together." That kind of resurrected Leon's career. I think the album was called The Union. Check it out. I don't know what comes up next, quite frankly. I'll put something on, but let's listen to our next tune. I'll talk about it afterwards.
You have a date for your best date tonight. Some distant bell starts chiming now. You wanna see her. You wanna see her. Oh yeah. So you wait and wait. Girl, don't come. The time rolls on, those minutes fly by. You wanna go, but just too tired. You wanna see her. You wanna see her. Oh yeah. So you wait and wait. Girl, don't come. You've been stood up, tears fill your eyes. Oh, you hurt inside. You wanna. You have a date for your best date tonight. Some distant bell starts chiming now. You wanna see her. You wanna see her. Oh yeah. So you wait and wait. Girl, don't come. You've been stood up, tears fill your eyes. Oh, oh. You hurt inside, you wanna die. Oh, you wanna see her. You wanna see her. Oh yeah. So you wait and wait. Girl, don't come. Girl, don't come. Girl, don't come.
Aha, got you on that one, didn't I? Chances are you have never heard of this artist that did Girl Don't Come. Her name is Sandy Shaw, and she was huge over in England. This, when she did this particular song, it was at the end of 1964. 1965 was just about ready to begin, and it actually came out on the B side of another one of her songs, and they switched it to the A side because it became such a hit. It got to, let's see, number one in Britain. Over here in the U.S., it actually did chart at the highest was number 42. Number two in Canada, though, not too far away. Sandy was the epitome of the era in which the Beatles were ushering in the whole British scene, Petula Clark, etc. But nobody had ever actually heard of a Sandy Shaw. I think that that song represents a great time period where you can just kind of picture the horns and that sort of thing. You can picture that whole British Carnaby 60s Twiggy scene over there. What we're about to hear is, I think, a great example of what they called psychedelic rock. And a matter of fact, one of its members, Mark Weitz, is in our focus group. And he is a founding member of the Strawberry Alarm Clock. I believe the lead singer on the following song, Incense and Peppermints, was a kid that couldn't have been even driving age yet when he sang this song. But Mark actually was the original writer of this song. He wrote the melody as an instrumental, and they pretty much morphed this into what is Incense and Peppermints. And if in fact he pokes his head in, he might be correcting me on some things. But let's take a listen to a song we've all heard, but it's great to listen to. The cover of that album was in itself a great symbol of the whole psychedelic 60s era. The colorful nature of the clothes that the Strawberry Alarm Clock band had on this album cover was something else. I'll probably post it online. And so here's Incense and Peppermints.
Occasions, bars, sweaters, clothes.
Incense and Peppermints, performed by Strawberry Alarm Clock. It's on the Billboard charts for 16 weeks and reaching number one in November of that year. Let's switch gears a little bit and let's talk about The Adventures of Panama Red. The New Riders of the Purple Sage was a band that included, at times, Jerry Garcia, the Grateful Dead, and they released their fourth album in 1973 called The Adventures of Panama Red, and included a song written by a guy that I saw up at Mount Hood, Oregon recently, and I had actually never heard of the dude before, but he did Panama Red. I found out that he wrote Panama Red. And it's a song that became a huge hit in 73 for New Riders of the Purple Sage. And let's listen.
Panama Red, Panama Red. They'll steal your woman and it'll rob your head. Panama Red, Panama Red. On the white horse, Mr. Toledo, he comes freezing through town. Let's go. Something's bed with old Panama Red. The judges don't know what the red's in town. It keeps well hidden underground. Everybody's acting lazy, falling out, they're hanging around. My woman said, hey Pedro, you're acting crazy like a clown. Nobody feels like working. Panama Red is back in town. Panama Red, Panama Red. This new woman, they can rob your head. Everybody's looking out for him because they know Red satisfies. Little girls like to listen to him sing, tell sweet lies. But when things get too confusing, honey, we're better off in bed. And I'm searching all the joints in town for Panama Red. Panama Red, Panama Red. It's dear your woman, then it'll rob your head. White horse, that's the lead, oh, he got a reason to town. Bet your woman is up in bed with old Panama Red, Panama Red, Panama Red. It's you, your woman, then it'll rob your head. Panama Red, Panama Red. On the white horse, that's the lead, oh, he got a reason to town. Bet your woman is up in bed with old Panama Red.
Well, Panama Red, it, you know, it was a it became an FM radio staple, and even though New Riders of the Purple Sage really never became a huge hit band or anything like that, their zenith was in the mid 70s, and you know, eventually these types of bands kind of made way for the next movement, which was let's call the outlaw country movement, which was best exemplified by Waylon and Willie and second wave country rock groups like the Eagles and Pure Prairie League and Firefall, and eventually New Riders morphed into, you know, members of the band went into other groups, and there's such a family tree of Grateful Dead splintered, inspired, splintered bands out there that it's, it would take 5 minutes to actually list them all. I guess next we're going to hear from Tom Waits. Well, that's good old Tom Waits, and this was actually from his first solo album called Closing Time. I guess some people think that it was the Eagles that did that song first. No, that actually Tom wrote that song and performed it on Closing Time in March of 73. It wasn't until 1974 that the Eagles did their Tom's old 55 on their album On the Border. And Waits was known as being critical of the Eagles' cover version of the song. In his words, "I was not particularly crazy about their rendition of it. I thought their version was a little antiseptic." Well, you know, once you've heard Tom. This next song is the only song that I could come up with that is one of my favorite songs by Fleetwood Mac, and this is the early Fleetwood Mac. It was off the Then Play On album when they were a blues oriented band. I would have to go look, and I will while the song plays, to see exactly who the guitarist is. I think it is Peter Green on Oh Well. And it was Oh Well Part 1 and Part 2 on Then Play On. I can't find that song. They have not released that. And I don't have it on CD. So I'm going to play a live version of it. This is called Oh Well.
But don't ask me what I think of you. I might not give an answer that you want me to.
Well, that's a big portion of Oh Well, Part 1. Part 2 kind of goes into a slower, an arrangement, acoustic part. And I wish I could play that for you. I've got to find a copy of that, and I'll do it in its entirety a little later on in this series of shows. We're going to close out with little Neil Young. He had done Everybody Knows This Is Nowhere with Crazy Horse in 1969, and played it live at Massey Hall in 1971. This is an amazing, amazing album. If you have not heard it, it's got great, great sound. It's as if he's sitting in front of you. You can hear my doggy in the background there. He does Cowgirl in the Sand during this concert in 1971. Neil Young, Cowgirl in the Sand. Until next time, this is Mark, and thanks for listening. You have a good day. And don't take things too seriously out there. Bye-bye now.
The woman in you that makes you want Hello, Ruby in the dust. Has your band begun to rust? After all the sin we've had, I was hoping that we'd turn back. Old enough now to change your name. When so many love you, is it the same? It's the woman in you that makes you wanna play this game. It's the woman in you that makes you wanna play this.